Hello there! Last week I made a video of a system, or method, that I've been working on for some time that will help you learn and draw tons of characters really fast and super easily. Link in the description if you're interested. But that video was all about drawing traditionally with pencil and paper. I thought I could make an Inkscape version of the same tutorial for those who prefer to draw with keyboard and mouse, and also to show how to apply the same concepts, but taking advantage of the tools of the program. So this video will be about adapting that method to Inkscape. And if you check out that video, which I strongly recommend you to, even if you don't plan to draw, the concepts are the important thing, you will notice that there are quite a few differences worth exploring. But before continuing, a quick plug. I'm currently working on a new character design course, and the subject of this video will be part of it, expanded and with more detail, of course. If you would like to help me during the production, I'm making available my special Inkscape courses bundle again, this time with the new course as an extra. That's 11 full Inkscape courses, over 70 hours of content on character design, background design, game art, and more, all aimed at beginners. The courses are the ones showing on the screen. If you're interested, the whole bundle costs only 19 bucks, and it will help me and the channel a lot. Link in the description. That was all, continuing with the video. The first step of the method is finding reference. What we want is a single character that we're gonna study, and there are a couple of things to keep in mind when you're picking the character, especially when working entirely in Inkscape. First of all, you need to find a character that can be easily made with keyboard and mouse. That means a character like this. Cartoon style, simple, maybe leaning a bit to a flat style, like the ones you see in Western cartoons. And the second requirement, and it's not that much of a requirement, but a recommendation when you're starting out, is to find characters that are more or less in a neutral standing pose, and if possible, in a front view. That will make everything much more easy. For the original video, I got this amazing character made by the artist Bar Guy. I was planning to use another different character for this video, but then I thought it may be more useful to see the differences by comparing the same method with the same character, but different medium. Also, the character happened to work fairly well with Inkscape anyway. So, import the image into Inkscape. It may be useful to lock it and lower the opacity. And you can do that by opening the Fill and Stroke dialog and lowering the opacity. And then, opening the Layers and Objects dialog and clicking in the little lock at the side of the image name. No need to create another layer or anything. The tracing is gonna be super simple. Now it's time to trace over with the pen tool. If you watched the previous video, which you should have, you'll know that what we want to do now is to find and trace only the big shapes. We want an indication of the shape and the proportions. We don't care about the details. Use rectangles and spheres and triangles, very simple shapes. So for example, the body will be just a single rectangle, the head will be a sphere and a triangle, and don't even bother with the arms, just a straight line will be enough. In the next step, we'll be moving these parts around to make new designs. That's the reason why we want them to be as simple as possible. If they are too complicated, modifying them and moving them around will be harder. So stay to super simple shapes that indicate only the rough shape and proportions of the reference. This simplified version of the character will work like a mannequin that later on will append the details. But I'm getting ahead of myself. For now we're ready with this step. Now let's move to the next one. So here's where the most important part of the technique comes in. So far, the mannequin we made matches the shape of the original artwork. If we wanted, we could start to copy the details and begin really learning and memorizing the shapes and patterns that we could use later on in our own characters. But I've discovered that we can go one step beyond and make something much more instructive and fun. What we're gonna do now is to grab these shapes and make a duplicate, and then play around with the proportions and shapes to quickly build a completely different mannequin. Just use the object tool and scale and rotate and move all the shapes around. Maybe you can make the head twice as big as the original, or really squash the hat so it looks tiny in comparison. The same with the torso. Elongate it or make it shorter or wider. Grab the belt and put it all the way down or make it really big. And of course, you can always grab the pen tool and make modifications to the shape. Though, because of the goal of this method, I don't recommend you to mess too much with the shapes, at least not to the point they become unrecognizable from the original version. You'll see why later. Don't be shy to use the node tool, just don't go overboard with it. Just play around with the shapes and try to make the mannequin look like a completely different thing. The idea here is that you get to experiment with completely different designs, but with the support of the original shapes, and with the knowledge that everything fits. And that's the thing, you don't want to create a completely different character. You want variations that show how these shapes construct the design. That's the reason why I recommend you not to delete or add any shape, or that you strafe too far away from the original model. Like for example, removing the hat altogether or taking the belt off. That will come later in a future tutorial. For now, your goal is to study how these reference and shapes in particular can make up different designs. You see now why I insisted in the previous step to work with simple shapes, because they are much easier to manipulate and use the node tool if you need. You'll notice that I'm making more than a single copy. This is essential. In the original video I say that you'll need to do between 5 and 15 variations of each design to truly understand it and memorize the details, and it's the same here. The more variations you make, the more engaged you are with the way the design works, and the more you learn. So do a minimum of 5 variations per character you study. Other than that, just use your artistic sense and imagination to see what looks good and what could look nice in a finished character. Once you have a good quantity of variations you're happy with, it's time for the last step, and probably the most fun one. And this step is the one where you'll see the biggest difference with the previous video, because now we can make use of the tools of Inkscape to speed up the process and just be more effective. This step is all about adapting the details of the original to the new mannequins. In the original video, I just copied the details one by one from the original illustration, but now you can follow a different process. We're gonna trace over the original work and then distort these details to match the new mannequins. So once again, lower the opacity and lock the reference. And using the pen tool and built-in objects, start tracing over the shape. Very important, use closed shapes. Even if there are open areas, always use closed shapes. It makes everything easier. You can sample the color of the reference to see how it looks in color. And of course, you should go grouping the shapes of the objects as you are completing them, so they are easier to reuse. One very important thing here, we do not want any type of built-in shape in our groups. This is important because we are going to use the path effects to adapt them in the best possible way to the shape of the new mannequins. And path effects do not work well with groups that have a combination of pen-made shapes and built-in shapes. So don't forget to transform them to paths by going to Path, Object to Path. Once you're done, all objects should be separated in groups and ready to be reused. And that's what we're gonna do now. Grab these objects, duplicate them and try to make them fit into the shapes of the other mannequins. So here are a couple of tips to do that. Try to make them fit by using the least amount of modifications possible. It's not always gonna be possible to just move one object to the other side and make it fit, but whenever you can, only use the transformations of the object tool, and only as a last resource, start applying path effects. I'm sure you're wondering which path effects to use, and here are the ones I thought are the most important ones. For long limbs like the arms and legs, you can use the bend effect. This makes it enormously easy to adjust them to any position. For simple distortions of objects, use the envelope deformation. And for the more complex distortions, where you need to distort only some areas but not others, use lattice deformation. With these three, should be more than enough. If a character does not look 100% right, remember that this is only an exercise for learning and studying the details and practice. You're not gonna show this to anyone. And that's a very important point I want to make sure to leave completely clear. You shouldn't show this to anyone. These are not your own characters, no matter how different they look from the original. These are studies of the work made by other artists. Now, these studies could be the starting point for making your own characters later on, but I won't be dealing with that in this video. Make sure to check out the course when it's ready, where I do go on detail on how to create your very own characters properly. So that's it for today. While I still think that using pen and paper is better for drawing than going full keyboard and mouse with Inkscape, I still have a soft spot for it, and I think it has much more potential than what people give it credit for. So let me know in the comments what are your thoughts about this method. And one final thing, I make videos about Inkscape every week, If you're interested, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. Also, any like and comment is highly appreciated and helps the channel a lot. That's all for now. Bye!